All right, so what's up? Welcome back to the channel. So today I'm gonna be reacting to new Slaughter to Prevail song called "King of Dark," a "Kid of Darkness," sorry, not "King of Darkness." Oh, by the way, I got a new microphone. Here. So I'm using it to record right now. So anyway, let's go. 4 minute song. Sure, it's deathcore. It makes sense that it'll be 4 minutes. Why are there subtitles in Japanese? Okay. Got some lo-fi guitar. Nice. Nice melodic guitar there. Holy shit. What the hell is that sound in the background? Okay, we're going with this horse. Holy shit, blast beats. Okay, still blast beating though. Ooh. Bro, their drum is insane. Oh, I love this guitar in the background. More brass beats, man. Oh shit. Got the melody there. Again. Nice. Oh, I know we're going. Break down. Come on. Break down. Ooh, some lo-fi drums. A little bit of toms as well. Ooh. Melodic breakdown. Oh, my thinky. That's some pinch harmonic there. Not sure though. What the bill? The fucking DT whammy pedal. This man say. Well, is it not over? It's not over. I don't think it's over. Where are we going? Okay. Still midnight with some building. Holy shit. Holy fuck. Shit. So many pinch harmonics. Ooh, is that a soul? Kind of? Not that Slaughter to Prevail solos are always like easy to play and very melodic. Honestly, this ending kind of reminds me of Baba Yaga. Like the... Both the... Okay, so that ending kind of reminded me of the ending for Baba Yaga and the ending from Night for... what's it called? 1984. Like with a solo... And with a melodic, slow, easy to play solo. And some... And a little bit emotional, I guess. Oh, that was a great song. I don't really have a lot to say about it. It's just good. Just slaughtered to prevail, being slaughtered to prevail, I guess. Oh, that ending breakdown had a lot of, what's it called? A lot of, come on,
fuck.
Pinch harmonics, right. Oh, it had a lot of pinch harmonics. Yeah, alright, so thanks for watching and bye.